With home prices at an all-time high, low inventory, and the market shows no sign of slowing down, it's very common nowadays for a home to be listed for sale and end up receiving multiple offers in the same day. No matter how good one offer is, another offer may win the contract. Understanding how backup contracts work is critical today, and it's time we take the mystery out of the backup contract. Hi, my name is Kelly Yount. Thanks for joining us again for Coffee with Capital. I have had several questions this week regarding backup contracts, so I thought it might be time to revisit, since multiple offers have become such a common practice in our market. So let's break down and understand the mysteries that surround having a backup contract. The addendum for a backup contract confuses a lot of people. When you have an executed backup contract, you have a contract that the buyer has the unrestricted right to terminate prior to it moving into first contract position. But the seller does not have the unrestricted right to terminate the backup contract once executed. The backup contract is contingent on the first contract terminating. If the first contract terminates before the deadline given in paragraph B of the backup addendum, then the second contract becomes effective as of this new date. The new effective date changes to the date the buyer receives notice of the termination of the first contract. The day that notice is given becomes the amended effective date. And now the clock starts ticking on the option period. The option period on the backup contract does not begin until the backup contract moves into the first contract position. The only performance due on a backup contract prior to it being in first position is that the option fee and the earnest money have to be paid as provided in the contract. Many times on a backup contract, the earnest money and option money is much lower. Many times on a backup contract, the earnest and the option money negotiated is far less than if it were the first contract. If the backup contract is moved into the first contract position, only now the buyer will proceed in their option period with any inspections or repair negotiations. But if the first contract does not terminate by the date given in paragraph B of the addendum, then the backup contract terminates and the earnest money will be refunded to buyer. I hope this helps clear up any confusion. If not, or if you have any questions regarding a backup contract, as well as anything else, please do not hesitate to reach out. You will find all my contact information in the video description. That's it for our coffee break today. Thank you for dropping by. My name is Kelly Yount with Capital Title, and I look forward to seeing you soon.